Hola, I am teacher Catalina, and I teach Spanish. Today we're learning subject pronouns. En español, pronombres personales. And we will do that in under 5 minutes. By the way, if you want to get free materials to learn Spanish, go to teachercatalina.com. There's a lot of great resources. So let's start. Subject pronouns, pronombres personales. Basically, they replace names. So let's look at an example. Let's say his name is Juan. We could say, Juan is tall. But we could also say, he is tall. He is what we call a subject pronoun. It replaced the name Juan. Let's look at another example. These are Juana, Pedro, and Roberto. We could say, Pedro, Juana, and Roberto are friends. Or we could use the subject pronoun and say, they are friends. They is what we call the subject pronoun. It replaced their name. In both of these cases, we use subject pronouns to replace the names, or what we call in Spanish, pronombres personales. So now we can go into more detail. Let's look at the subject pronouns in English, and then we can go over them in Spanish. I, you, he, she, it, we, you, which is plural, and they. Those are the subject pronouns in English. So now let's talk about los pronombres personales. En español, to say I, you would say yo, yo. You is tú, tú. He, él, él. She, ella, ella. Now, in Spanish, we do not have an it. In Spanish, things are either a he or a she. And we will discuss this more later. Now, we also have another subject pronoun that is usted, and it's abbreviated as UD period. You don't have the subject pronoun in English. In Spanish, it's a you formal. So what is the difference between you informal and you formal? Well, tú we use with family or friends, informal. And usted is going to be used in situations that are a little bit more formal, which is why I'm drawing this tie here to help you remember. Formality. To go more in depth in the difference between tú and usted, check out this video lesson here that I have for you. Let's continue with the plural forms. To say we could say nosotros, nosotros, if you are a group of males and you are a male, or we could say nosotras, nosotras, if you are a group of females and you are a female. Remember, we includes you. Now, I know you're thinking, what if we have a mixed group? If we have a mixed group, we are going to use the masculine form nosotros. The moment when there is one male in the group, you use the masculine form. You plural is going to be vosotros, vosotros, or vosotras, vosotras. And this is going to be used only in Spain. And it's going to be used when we want to say you guys, you plural. The same rules from nosotros and nosotras apply. Basically, remember to pay close attention to the gender of the group. They would be ellos for a group of males or a mixed group, and ellas for a group of girls, and you're saying they. Now, ustedes is going to be the equivalent of vosotros and vosotras. It's abbreviated into UDS, and it's basically your you plural, kind of like saying you guys. You're talking to a group of people. Ellos and ellas, you're talking about them, while ustedes, you're talking to a group. And that's it, friends. You now know the subject pronouns in Spanish. Chócalas. Give me 5. You did it. Now you can comfortably use subject pronouns, pronombres personales. One more time, I am teacher Catalina, and I am so happy that you joined me. I would like to invite you to smash that me gusta like button. It really helps my channel. And if you have not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Click that subscribe button so that we can keep learning Spanish together. And while you're at it, click that notification bell so you know when there's new videos. And don't forget, teachercatalina.com for a lot of free Spanish learning resources. I hope to see you next time. Adios.